Hello folks, it's Barry. Welcome to My Virgin Kitchen. Hope you're well. Today, we are going to be reviewing some food gadgets that I have been sent in. I've got quite a few to get through, and we're going to try and work out if they're pretty pointless, and we don't want to ever use them again, or they're pretty worthwhile. So let's just get cracking and start with the first one. So this first one is shaped like a heart kind of thing, but it's actually a strawberry shape that it's supposed to be. I've made a little incision in the plastic, so let's get it straight out. This, my friends, is a strawberry slicer. For the ultimate in laziness, when you don't want to slice a strawberry, you open it up like so, apparently. Oh, crikey, yep. those are some razor sharp blades right there. There's rows of blades. I do not want to put my finger in there. It could be quite an interesting torture trap. So I guess we just stick a strawberry in there. And I do have a strawberry right now. I haven't even washed it. We're just going to go straight in. Shall I take the stem off, the little hole? I might just pull that out just to make it a little bit tidier. Don't want to make herbs, strawberry herbs. Wow, that nearly came down and cut my finger. Right, so our strawberry is in there. The packaging's quite bland on this, really. There's nothing really else to tell you about it. And I guess we just push down. Yes. Oh, wow. Crikey, I'm glad my finger didn't get caught in that. That last click, it really did pop into place. All right, you lift it out and the strawberry, what? I've got a little bit of strawberry here. Let's just get these out on the board. Okay. Again, I nearly cut my finger off. You've got some nice strawberry slices. They are cut nice and flush. That would be pretty darn cool for a cake or something like that. And it is quite hard sometimes to get a strawberry cut accurately. So maybe they also double up as earrings like that. I might use that again. I'll let you know if I do, but it's not the worst of the batch. Now, this is one of the only ones that I've sort of seen before. This is basically a pineapple corer slash slicer by Flagship, as seen on TV, also as seen on YouTube now. Pretty cool. And basically, we're going to take off the lid of the pineapple. I have a feeling that my pineapple might be too big, but we'll just go with that. So we basically cut it, so we reveal the top there, and then we get our Flagship pineapple cutter to work. It's going to get out of the box now. Oh, wow. You can see they put a lot of effort into the packaging, that thing. Is that like some sort of razor sharp pizza blade thing? Yeah, I guess. And then there's this handle there that looks like one of those lawn cutter things. So just push that in there. Is that right? Yes. It's quite a sharp blade here and in there. So I imagine this is going to go through the whole thing. Here we go. Just going to push this in. Oh, yes. So I pushed it in and there was like a little, it sort of bit. So, I'm just turning this, and the handle's just broken. The handle has just broken on this. I'm gonna just do it by the stem, so to speak. That, I tell you what, that is actually working. Just gonna bear with me a minute. I don't know how I know when to stop. Is it when it hits my chopping board or I've made a massive like dent in my workspace? I kinda wanna do a dance with it. Here it comes. Oh my gosh! It's like childbirth. Did you see that? Check that out. That is amazing. So we've got pineapple slices right there. They're all sort of cut into nice little strips like this. It's like one of those slides, like a helter-skelter or something. I really like that. Plus, if you have that, you've got an amazing pina colada style drinking cup. If you like pina coladas, that's a good gadget. I like that one. There's actually some fresh pineapple juice in the bottom of it as well. Wow. That's good. So this one to me does seem very pointless indeed. This is a silicon garlic peeler. So it peels cloves of garlic, okay? Not to be confused with whole bulbs of garlic, so just your cloves, okay? This isn't the only garlic peeler gadget I've got. I've also randomly got this thing as well, which is shaped more like a bulb of garlic, and I've never ever used it. So we can put one in this one, and then one in this one. And apparently all we do is rub them. This is the official quote from Amazon. Rub them until you hear a crinkly sound and it could take a couple of minutes. So let's go. Little update, my chopping board is going everywhere. So you should put a wet cloth underneath it. I'll do that in a minute, it stops it moving. And my kitchen's starting to smell of garlic. I can hear papery noises, but I'm gonna give it, this angle looks so wrong. I'm gonna give it a little bit longer. Right, now I'm changing my mind. I'm gonna do a bit of force. Oh yeah, on each one. Oh, there we go. Check that out. It's just popped out again, a bit like childbirth. All these gadgets are a bit replicating childbirth, if you ever want to know what it's like. I've experienced it twice and now for a third time with a garlic clove. So my other one, this rubby garlic thing there. Now that's rubbish. Let's stick with the garlic peeler tube thing. Kind of works. We have got ourselves one bold garlic clove, but even still, now it's popped up, you've still got to pick it up. So you are going to stink of garlic anyway. All right, so we've got a damp tea towel under there now, so hopefully this board won't move so much. This is a jar of olives. I absolutely hate olives, FYI. And this is, I kid you not, pretty much how it arrived. It was loose like this in the box. Some of the packaging was terrible. An olive and cherry pitta. I do not know why I didn't buy cherries, because I love cherries, but olives, I'm not such a fan. That is pretty much it. I don't know if there's any instructions on the back. Use the tool for pitting both olives and cherries. Fast and easy. Ergonomically designed and dishwasher safe. Oh, I can feel the ergonomics in that. They've done a good effort. So it's got a little safety latch. We're going to let that go. And you could see again, that could be some sort of medieval tool as well. We won't go down that route. So I'm going to take out an olive. Might have to eat it on camera just to justify this. And the stone. I hope I've bought ones that aren't pitted, because that would defeat the whole point of the gadget, unless it just makes them disappear. So there we go. We have got an olive in there. And I guess we just line this up. Quite a fat olive, actually. Don't know if it's going to fit in. There we go. Is it going to work? I don't know. I'm going to have to really push that in if this one's going to fit that well, but we're just going to go for it. So here we go. Olive pitta. Push it through. Is that stone? No. Is it left a stone in there? Yes, it has. Look at that. That hasn't worked. Right, let's try it again. Let's get another olive. Let's do it at the other end with the bum hole facing upwards. It's just taking the lid off it and revealing the stone. Maybe that's what it is. I'm a tool that embraces the pits in olives. Yeah, great. All right, we're gonna try it one last time, and I'm gonna try and line this up as much as I can. Just push it. No. Would you look at that? That is terrible. That is a terrible gadget. Ladies and gents, why have a knife when you can have a Geelong MSC, sounds like they've been to college and putting letters after their name, perfectly sliced tomatoes, and they're also good for potatoes and onions. So this is a lazy man's tomato slicer. We've got to get this out, have a little look. Don't think there's that much else on the box. Wow. That is a firm thing. It looks like a hair clipper. In fact, that is it. Someone has just bought a hair clip. Rap, 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 rap. Maybe some sort of fish? That does look like a goldfish from that angle, doesn't it? Maybe. Forgot that. No. Hair clip. We'll go for hair clip. Basically, all someone has done is they've got a hair clip and gone, do you know what? If we stick a tomato in that, like this, and then clamp it, you can, like, slice tomatoes. I would love to be the person that realised that. Anyhow, what we do is get our very sharp knife, I presume. I want to hold it. I want to grip it more, but I'm not going to. I'm just going to hold it down here. And then we just slice down. Where are the slices going? Just slice down like this. Okay, yeah, that's cool. It's holding it now. At first, I held it near the spring and it wanted to escape. So don't hold it there. If you happen to buy one of these tomato slices, let's do one last slice. And then if we open it up, well, hey, I tell you what, that is how you slice a tomato, but you have got a free hair clip. We're on the home straight now, ladies and gents. Now this, and again, this is exactly how it came, the packaging like that, very loose. As seen on TV, once again, is a cucumber slicer. And on the back, over the sticky label bit, it looks like you're spiralizing a cucumber, which is all the rage at the moment. Hey, I just spiralized my salad. Like, just eat the salad, ain't gonna make it any better. Anyhow, cucumber is gonna go in here in a minute. This has got like a disky thing on the back, like a semicircle of a disc. It's clear plastic, it's angled slightly, it's not too sharp. This bit is a little bit more. And the other end of it, where I presume I push the cucumber in, it's got like an angled stem, kind of like a slide again in the middle. So it's all like a corkscrew effect right in there. So what we're gonna do is push our cucumber into the meshy bit, I presume, like this. Oh, wow, okay. That kind of felt too good. And then we just turn it. Can you see if anything's happening? Oh, yes, it is. Yes, it is, my friends. We are making slices of cucumber. Now, there's a gadget that I reviewed recently with my daughter Phoebe. I've done some other gadget videos. I'll put a little playlist link up above. It's a carrot sharpener, and that was terrible. And a lot of you said, oh no, it needs to be a blunt end. I did that. In fact, it's right here. If I can open my drawer. There it is. That's a carrot sharpener. A bit pointless. I actually had two of those in the end. But this one is working. And I absolutely hate cucumber. So this is a bit pointless. Mrs. Barry's going to have like a whole cucumber protest when she gets home. But let's have a little taste.
I hate cucumber.
I'm gonna leave my two personal favorites for the end, and this is one of them. It's called Stem, again, as seen on TV. And basically it's a lemon or citrus spray, as a lime there, and it comes with a base. They've got two different size ones there, I guess basically depending on the size of your lemon or lime, and it's got a lid on it. So you can sort of spray away, kind of like, you know, you can get your lemon like that and be like, aftershave, lemon for men, all that kind of stuff. But there is actually a famous celebrity chef called Heston Blumenthal. He did fish and chips in a restaurant. It was a quirky thing. I don't know if he still does it, where he would spray the smell of chips, I think, in the air to like really incentivize it and all that stuff. But they're saying that you spray it on salads and in water and stuff like that. So let's make some lemon aftershave. All right, we're taking the lid off, and it says on the other side, I just caught that, the freshest mist. And actually already, I am getting a good waft of lemon from there. So we're gonna go for the smaller lid and push that right into our lemon, like so. Maybe screw it around as well, get it to bite. Okay, cool, let me clear this down. Apart from this, this must be our base that holds it, and it sort of leans it, leaning tower of lemon. So yeah, I've screwed that down so that sort of silicony bit has gripped it, and it now really is aftershave for men. Don't print screen that, okay? So here we go, we're just gonna spray. I'm just gonna do it here. Oh my gosh, I got a bit of spray out then. Here we go. Yes, I'm just spraying lemon randomly around my kitchen. Quite a good air freshener, actually. You do get like those lemon scented air fresheners. Just buy a lemon, stick one of these in it, and that. But you're supposed to spray it on a salad. So let's pretend we've got a nice salad there. Nom, 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 nom. It's all right, that'll do. Spray lemon on someone. Okay, it can also work if you want to sort of freshen your breath. But of course you could use a watermelon or an orange. Hey, your breath smells like orange. Anyhow, last gadget is this thing. Now I posted a picture on my Snapchat and Instagram, all that stuff, saying, what is this thing, guys? Can you guess what it is that kind of looks like a shoehorn? Well, let me reveal it for you, because if I bring in this thing, guess what this does to this, okay? You're probably getting it right now. Some of you did guess it actually online. This is a cake slicer. Now it's weird because it's got a sort of funny curve on it. But what we do is basically just press down on here. It has got sort of slightly sharper edges on one. Get it right down there. There we go. Take it out. And that is a slice of cake. That's quite cool. And you're left with quite a weird sort of ninja slice in the cake as well. Oh, I just dropped the cake. Oh. Yeah, I've just done another slice there. And look, as long as you grip it, unlike what I just did and the slice went everywhere, it does hold it quite well. So there we go, nice bit of portion control as well, because you know you go to a kid's birthday party, you know, it's the, like, incentive for dad's going, right? You get a bigger slice, so here we go. Coke. There we are then, folks, that's all the food gadgets reviewed for today. As I say, I have done other reviews in the past of other food gadgets, so please feel free to check them out. My favorite one today was the good old lemon sprayer. I feel that lemon aftershave is definitely the way forward. Don't forget to subscribe, and also let me know on social media any other cool food gadgets you've seen. I'll see you again next time. That was a sound effect, but yeah, it is actually lemon aftershave. Mm.